Hi everybody, Mark Moorhead, Curator of Education here at the Hall of Flame Museum of Firefighting in Phoenix, Arizona. And we are the world's largest historical firefighting museum. And you know what we love to do. If you can't come into the museum, we love to bring the museum to you. And today, we're gonna kind of start at the beginning. This is the display that we call, it's number 50 in the collection, but in our hearts, this is number one. This was the first truck, the truck that started the Hall of Flame Museum of Firefighting. And we have some rare fire trucks here at the museum, but this is a really common fire truck. This is the kind of fire truck you would have seen all over America, other parts of the world as well, in the 1920s, 1930s, 1940s, into the 1950s. This one was built in 1924 by the American LaFrance Corporation, then of Elmira, New York. Now, if you ever see an old fire truck with a bell with an eagle on top of it like that, that's probably going to be an American LaFrance. That was kind of their trademark. And they built this truck in 1924, as you can see, for the city of Oshkosh, Wisconsin. And Oshkosh had it for a long time. They really built these things to last. So they had it from 1924 until 1955, 31 years on the job. When they retired it, they decided to sell it off, and it was sold to this nice lady, whose name was Olive Getz, and she bought it as a gift, really a gag gift, kind of a joke, for this man, her husband, whose name was George Getz. And Mr. Getz was a very wealthy man, and they were driving apparently through Wilmette, Illinois one day, and out in front of a car dealership, they saw an old fire truck, an old vintage fire truck on sale, and he just remarked, oh, geez, it'd be fun to have one of those things. And so what do you get for the man who has everything, right? So his wife instructed their son, Bert, as soon as he was able to go back secretly and buy it. Somehow or another, they kept it secret from Mr. Getz. They gave it to him on Christmas Day, 1955. And it was intended a little bit as just kind of a gag gift maybe, but he loved it, you know? And he went nuts for it, and he was given his kids and neighborhood kids rides in it, and it eventually became a reserve vehicle for the Lake Geneva, Wisconsin Fire Department, and he really got interested in fire trucks, and he started to collect more and more and more of them. She had no idea what she started, right? And the result is this museum. Really very soon, 1961, he had enough for a small museum there in Kenosha, Wisconsin, and some friend of his said he should call it the Hall of Flame, and so he did, and that was really how we began. A few years later, the family moved out here, and they brought the collection with them, and we've been in this location here near the Phoenix Zoo since 1973. And in that time, gradually, we've grown into the largest historical firefighting museum in the world, and it was all because of this truck. So we're very fond of this truck. Now, when you're talking about the great fire truck makers, a lot of different automotive firms have made fire trucks. Mack makes excellent fire trucks. We got a bunch of them. Ford makes fire trucks. Chevy, Dodge make fire trucks. There were Stutz, the famous Bearcat people, you know, they specialized in luxury cars and racing cars, but they also made some fire trucks. We have one here. But there were a few companies that sort of specialized in fire trucks. Seagrave, Aaron's Fox, there were a few others, but probably the most famous of those was American LaFrance. They also made city buses, but their real specialty was fire trucks. And they made this fire truck for Oshkosh in the 20s. We have another one from Pullman, Washington that they made in the 20s, but we have them from way across the boards. We have one of our most beloved trucks in the museum is a 1951 cab forward American LaFrance from Miami, Arizona, which is the one that we let kids and grownups, if they want to, climb on and have a lot of fun on. And as a result, it's probably the most beloved truck in our collection, even if it doesn't have the finest finish. We have a fire truck from an American LaFrance from 1948 that we just recently acquired. Beautiful truck from Jamestown, North Dakota. And so we got all kinds of American LaFrance. Now, another question that we're very, very frequently asked here at the Hall of Flame is, what's with the right-hand drive on some of these old fire trucks? This one, our beloved Oshkosh, has right-hand drive. We have several other trucks that have right-hand drive, but they're American trucks. You can understand it, of course, in a British or European truck, but not an American truck. Well, what that goes back to is there's no firefighting reason for it. A lot of people wonder if there's some reason why a firefighter might need right-hand drive. There isn't that I can think of. It has to do with the industrial practices of the early 20th century. The trucks that you'll find here, there's this one, there's one from Phoenix, Arizona, that have the right-hand drive, and they are American trucks, and those trucks came from the very early 1920s or earlier. In those days, they didn't really know what side of the road where they were gonna drive in. You just kind of drove wherever you could get through. And eventually they standardized it, and of course in America, they standardized the left-hand drive. When they built fire trucks, a lot of times they were working from some older design, and they didn't want to have to redo the design, redo the factory, retool everything to build it with the new standard left-hand drive. So they just kept building them with the right-hand drive. And what you find is that when you get into the later 1920s or into the 1930s, certainly, fire trucks built for the Americans had their steering wheels over here. But in this case, on this 1924 Oshkosh American LaFrance, you were driving down the road, sitting on the right-hand side if you were the driver, and if you were on the left-hand side and sitting where we would think of as being the driver's seat, what you had to do was ring the bell, that famous American LaFrance bell with the eagle on top of it, or a more newfangled invention, but one that was very effective, which was the siren. But a siren isn't like today where you push the button and the siren comes out. You had to hand crank it like an ice cream maker. But as you can see, it really does sound like a siren. So by the time that you get to the fire, the guy driving here has been driving with no power steering, and the guy over here has been ringing this bell and cranking this siren all the way down the street. So they're pretty much done. They're pretty much exhausted. But they did their job well, as did this truck. And it's one of the ones that we're the most proud of here at the Hall of Flame. And we're very glad to share it with you today. I'm Mark Moorhead, Curator of Education here at the Hall of Flame Museum of Firefighting. Check back in soon. Bye-bye.